When I first started dancing, I just wanted to become the best dancer in the world. But then as you get advanced, you understand that there's actually no such thing. Hi Mix TV, welcome to my pad. My name is Huck and I'm a dancer and a choreographer. I was born in Japan and at the age of 3, my whole family, we moved to Oxford in England. And at 12, I moved back to Tokyo. And at that point, it was really confusing too because, you know, I look Japanese and I'm completely blood-wise Japanese, but inside I was very English. So yeah, I decided to come to America and I never thought that I'll be able to work as a dancer and choreographer. I mean, when I first came to the States, I didn't know anything. I was completely Asian. So I was like, okay, dance equals hip hop equals black people. That's why I joined the Black Students Union when I first came out here. And that was just a really innocent way of thinking. This is the random weird shelf, you know? Sometimes it helps. You know Mega Man? If you don't, you should. With Quest Crew, I went to a B-Boy Jam and I met Ryan. We wanted to form a new crew. From there, it was really just sort of friends and whoever we thought was dope and could offer something new to the mix, we would just hang out more and we would invite them. And yeah, slowly but surely, it just kind of built and built and built because of the way it sort of formed. I know that it's gonna be a family forever. My parents are definitely, I don't think they were ever against me dancing. They're very open-minded, but very strict. After high school, I said I wanted to go to a school that specialized in dance, and they said no. They're the type of people that are not easily impressed, but he would always say that I had to do my schoolwork and study and do my house chores first, and then after that, if you have time, you can dance. The fact that they were really strict really pushed me. And they're Japanese, they don't really surface emotions too much, they don't really verbalize it, but yeah, I think they're proud of me.
I really like the weirdness of like animation. It has like a weird texture to it. And then I also like the tut stuff where it's basically, you do stuff with like box grid oriented stuff, but I like to mix it up because it's like you can do it with your hands or you can kind of come down and do it with your legs and you make angles, boom, with your legs too, boom. And add threads, boom. So it's like a jigsaw puzzle that you get to sort of mix everything together.
I don't know if there was ever a moment where it kind of hit me where I thought that I could live off of dancing, but I do remember a specific moment that when I was able to earn money from dancing and eat what I wanted in a restaurant. As a student, I was super broke. I would go to the cafeteria, get $1 spicy chicken sandwich and water, you know. It's like, yes, save some money.
I love my kitchen. My favorite thing about the kitchen is my fridge. Favorite item inside my fridge is this citrus pepper from Japan. If you hadn't had it before, missing out, put it on any meat, chicken, you go to heaven right away.
I don't think there was ever a point where it was so tough that I wanted to quit because it's like, it's tough, but I didn't do this because I wanted to have an easy life, you know? It's like, if you want something, yeah, it's gonna be hard, but that shouldn't really be an issue. And I feel like I've always had that perspective on things, that something being hard is never a negativity to me.
My motto is if there's something that you truly want to do, go ahead and do it. You know, there's really no one and nothing stopping it except yourself. And just understand that things aren't going to be easy. You know, some things might be really hard, the things are going to be so tough that you're going to want to quit. But at the end of the day, if you really want it, you just have to go for it. You know, and that way, you're never going to regret anything.